Hello everyone, welcome to the lecture series on open channel flow. In this video we will discuss the hydraulic jump that occur in horizontal rectangular channel. We will derive the expression of sequent depth ratio and relative energy loss. So to start this derivation, we must know the idea about the generalized momentum equation for hydraulic jump that we derived in our previous lecture. So this is the generalized linear momentum equation for hydraulic jump, where P1 is the pressure force which act in the control surface at section 1, and its expression is gamma A1 Y1 prime cos theta. Okay. Gamma is the unit weight of water, A1 is the area of flow at section 1, Y1 prime is the depth of CG from the free water surface at section 1, and theta is the bed slope of channel. In similar way, P2 is gamma A2 Y2 prime cos theta. A2 is the area of flow at section 2 and Y2 prime is the depth of CG from the free surface at section 2. W is the weight of the volume of water that we considered. This is the weight of control volume of water. Fs is the frictional force that act in opposite direction to the flow. M2 and M1 are the momentum flux. And the expression of M2 and M1 are M2 is equal to beta 2 rho q V2, where beta 2 and beta 1 are the momentum correction factor. Rho is the mass density of water, q is the discharge in the flow, discharge in the channel, and V2 and V1 are the mean velocity at section 2 and section 1 respectively. Now let's see the hydraulic jump in a horizontal rectangular channel. Let's consider a horizontal frictionless rectangular channel, and here we are considering the width of channel is unit, means 1. The momentum equation for this condition will be reduced to P1 minus P2 is equal to M2 minus M1. Why? Because here we are considering a frictionless channel, that's why the Fs term will be ignored. And since the bed of the channel is horizontal, means theta is equal to 0. That's why this W sine theta term will be 0, as the sine 0 is equal to 0. So P1 minus P2 is equal to M2 minus M1 will be the momentum equation for the case horizontal rectangular channel. Now P1 is equal to gamma A Y1 prime cos theta. Okay, here theta is 0, that's why cos 0 is 1. So gamma A1 is the area of flow at section 1. This is section 1 before the jump, and this is section 2 after the jump. Okay. So A1 is the area of flow at section 1-1, and A2 is the area of flow at section 2-2. So A1 will be B Y1, but here we are assuming that B is equal to 1. Okay. We are analyzing the hydraulic jump for the rectangular channel of unit width. So that's why we will take here only y1 prime is the depth of cg from the free water surface, and that will be y1/2. Cos 0 is 1. So p1 is equal to gamma half gamma y1 square. In similar way, p2 is equal to half gamma y2 square. M2 is the momentum flux in longitudinal direction going out through the control surface. Okay, and M1 is the momentum flux in the longitudinal direction going in through the control surface. And the expression of M2 is beta 2 rho q V2, and expression of M1 is beta 2 rho q V1. Let's take discharge per unit width is small q. Okay, discharge per unit width is small q. So here the width of the channel is 1, that's why small q will be equal to capital Q. So replace this capital Q by small q, then this will become beta 2 rho q V2, and this will become beta 1 rho q V1. Now substitute the value of P1, P2, M2 and M1 in this equation. Half gamma y1 square minus half gamma y2 square is equal to beta 2 rho q V2 minus beta 2 rho q V1. Let's take beta 2 and beta 1 are 1. Okay, means here we are assuming that the distribution of velocity is uniform at section 1 and section 2. But remember, between the portion between the section 1 and 2, in this portion we cannot assume the velocity distribution as a uniform, because hydraulic jump is taking in this portion. Okay, we are taking the extremes of the hydraulic jump. Okay, this section 1 is the at the commencement of hydraulic jump, and section 2 is at the end of the hydraulic jump. That's why here it is possible to assume velocity distribution as uniform. Then this equation will become half gamma y1 square minus half gamma y2 square is equal to rho q v2 minus v1, and this gamma we can write as this rho we can replace by gamma upon g. Okay, because gamma is equal to rho g, so here gamma and gamma will get cancelled. Then this equation will reduce to half y1 square minus y2 square is equal to q upon g v2 minus v1. Okay, or we can write this y2 square minus y1 square is equal to 2q divided by g v1 minus v2. Now from the continuity equation, q is equal to a1 v1 is equal to a2 v2. Okay, here a1 is dy1 and a2 is by2, divide b in each term, then this will be small q, this will be v1 y1, and this will be v2 y2. Okay, or directly we can write this small q is equal to v1 y1 is equal to v2 y2, because here width is taking as unity. Okay, now replace the value of v1 and v2 by q divided by y1 and q divided by y2 respectively in this equation, then this equation will become y2 square minus y1 square is equal to 2q divided by g q divided by y1 minus q divided by y2, y2 square minus y1 square is equal to 2q square divided by g y2 minus y1 divided by y1 y2, or y, this y2 square minus y1 square is y2 minus y1 y2 plus y1 is equal to 2q square divided by g y2 minus y1 divided by y1 y2. Okay, this will get cancelled and the equation will become y1 y2, y1 plus y2 is equal to 2q square divided by g. Okay, and we know the expression of critical depth for rectangular channel in terms of unit discharge small q is yc cube is equal to q square divided by g. So replace the value of q square divided by g by yc cube, then this expression will be 2yc cube. Y1 y2, y1 plus y2 is equal to 2yc cube. Now this is the relation between secant depth and unit discharge and critical depth. Now we try to non-dimensionalize this expression. So for this, take this portion only. Okay, divide y1 cube in both the sides then this y1 and this y1 will get cancelled and this power will reduce to square, and take one y1 below y2 and one y1 inside this bracket. Okay, then this will become y2 divided by y1 and this will become 1 plus y2 divided by y1 is equal to 2q square divided by g y1 cube. Now we know the expression of Froude number for rectangular channel is v divided by root over gy. If we talk about Froude number for supercritical flow or before the jump, then this will be f1 is equal to v divided by root over gy1. Now replace the value of v in terms of unit discharge, then this will become q divided by root over g y1 cube, because v is equal to q upon y. Now square both side f1 square will be equal to q square divided by g y1 q. Okay, so this term is nothing but f1 square. So this is equal to 2f1 square. Now multiply this y2 divided by y1 by this 1 plus y2 divided by y1, then this will become y2 divided by y1 plus y2 divided by y1 square, y2 divided by y1 minus 2f1 square is equal to 0. Okay, this is a quadratic equation. We can compare this equation by the standard quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0 to find the solution. Here x is nothing but y2 divided by y1, a is here, a is in this equation, a is 1, b is 1 and c is minus 2f1 square. Okay, so a is equal to 1, b is equal to 1, c is equal to minus 2f1 square. The solution of this quadratic equation is x is equal to minus b plus minus square of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Okay, so in similar way we can find the solution for this equation. Here x will be nothing but y2 divided by y1 for this expression is equal to minus b. Okay, b is 1 square minus 4, a is also 1 and c is minus 2f1 square whole divided by 2a is 1. So y2 divided by y1 is equal to minus 1 plus minus root over 1 minus minus will be plus, so this will be plus 4 to the 8 f1 square divided by 2. Okay, or y2 divided by y1 is equal to half of minus 1 plus minus square of square root 1 plus 8 f1 square. This is the expression of secant depth ratio in terms of Froude number. Okay, in similar way we can write y1 divided by y2 is equal to half of minus 1 plus minus square root of 1 plus 8 f2 square. Okay, this is the secant depth ratio in terms of Froude number after the jump. This is the expression of secant depth ratio in terms of Froude number before the jump. Okay, if we take y2 divided by y1, then we will use f1, and for y1 divided by y2 we will use f2. Now let's find the energy loss in the hydraulic jump occurring in a horizontal rectangular channel. Energy loss, EL, energy loss is the difference between the energy at section 1 and section 2. We know the total energy in case of open channel flow is datum energy or datum head plus depth of flow plus V square divided by 2G. Since here the channel bed is horizontal, that's why the datum energy at section 1 and section 2 will be same, and here because of the negative sign the datum energy will get cancelled. That's why we are ignoring the term Z. So H1 will be Y1 plus V1 square divided by 2G, and for section 2 S2 will be Y2 plus V2 square divided by 2g. Now replace the value of V1 and V2 in terms of unit discharge. Then this will become Y1 plus Q square divided by 2GY1 square minus Y2 plus Q square divided by 2GY2 square. Y1 minus Y2 plus Q square divided by 2G. 1 divided by y1 square minus 1 divided by y2 square. Okay, we can write this expression in this form also. y1 minus y2 plus 1 by 2. This q square upon g is here from this expression. Okay. This expression we can replace the value of q square upon g by y1 y2 y2 plus y1 divided by 2. Okay, from this expression q square upon g is equal to y1 y2 y2 plus y1 divided by 2. One by two, y1 plus y2. Okay. 1 upon y1 square minus 1 upon y2 square. That will become y1 square y2 square y2 square minus y1 square. y1 minus y2 plus this 1 by 2 will be 1 by 4, and here y1 y2 will get cancelled. 1 by 4 y1 y2. Okay, this we are taking outside. y1 plus y2, y2 square minus y1 square will be y2 plus y1 and y2 minus y1. Now let's take y2 minus y1 common from these two terms. Then this equation will become y2 minus y1. This will, here minus 1 will come. Okay, minus 1 plus y1 plus y2 and y2 plus y1. Okay, this will be y2 plus y1 whole square divided by 4y1 y2. Okay, this we got earlier. Now take LCM 4y1 y2, then here it will be minus 4y1 y2 plus y2 plus y1 whole square, and this is nothing but y2 minus y1 whole square. Okay, so ultimately the expression of loss of energy in horizontal in case of hydraulic jump occurring in horizontal rectangular channel is y2 minus y1 whole cube divided by 4y1 y2. Okay, this is the expression of loss of energy in terms of secant depths. Now let's find the relative energy loss in hydraulic jump. Relative energy loss is the ratio of loss of energy and initial energy. E1 is the energy at section 1 which is taken by considering the channel bottom as a datum, means E1 is specific energy at section 1, means E1 is equal to Y1 plus V1 square upon 2G. Let's find EL divided by E1. Divide Y1 both in numerator and denominator. Okay, then EL divided by Y1 and E1 divided by Y1. Now, firstly, let's find EL divided by Y1 term. Okay, suppose this is equation number 1. Now let's find first EL divided by Y1. What is EL? EL is Y2 minus Y1 whole cube divided by 4Y1 Y2. Y2 minus Y1 whole cube divided by 4Y1 Y2. Okay, here we have to divide Y1. Okay, EL divided by Y1 we are finding, that's why in this term we have to divide Y1. Then this will become Y1 square. Now divide Y1 cube both in numerator and denominator. Then this equation will become Y2. This Y1 will go inside this bracket. Then this will become Y2 divided by Y1 minus 1. Whole cube divided by 4 times of Y2 divided by Y1. Okay, so this is EL divided by Y1. Now let's find E1 divided by Y1. E1 divided by Y1 is equal to E1 is Y1 plus Q square divided by 2G Y1 square. Here we have to divide Y1 in both the term. Then this will become 1 plus Q square divided by 2G Y1 cube. This is nothing but F1 square divided by 2, as we have seen earlier. Okay, F1 square is equal to Q square divided by G Y1 cube. Now put the value of E1 divided by Y1 and EL divided by Y1 in this equation number 1 to find the relative energy loss. Then we will have the final equation of relative energy loss is Y2 minus Y1. Y2 divided by Y1 minus 1. Whole cube divided by 4y2 divided by y1, 1 plus f1 square divided by 2. So this is the final expression of relative energy loss. This equation gives the fraction of initial energy lost in the hydraulic jump. This figure shows the variation of EL divided by E1 with respect to Froude number of supercritical flow. This figure highlights the enormous energy dissipating characteristic of the jump. Here at F1 is equal to 5, about 50% of the initial energy in the supercritical stream is lost, and at F1 is equal to 20, the percentage loss of energy is about 86%. This plot is also used as a device to find the relative energy loss once we know the Froude number of the supercritical stream when we design the energy dissipating devices. Here one more thing we can do with the expression of relative energy loss is we can substitute the value of secant depth ratio Y2 upon Y1 in terms of Froude number. Then the expression of relative energy loss will become minus 3 plus root over 1 plus 8 f1 square whole to the power 3 divided by 8 2 plus f1 square minus 1 plus square root of 1 plus 8 f1 square. On simplification, the expression of relative energy loss will be this one in terms of Froude number of supercritical flow. Okay, by knowing the F1 only, we can find the loss of energy with respect to initial energy. Now we come to classification of jumps. The hydraulic jumps in horizontal rectangular channels are classified into 5 categories based on the Froude number F1 of the supercritical flow. First type of jump is undular jump. In this type of jump, the Froude number ranges between 1 to 1.7. Okay, this figure shows the undular jump. In this type of jump, the water surface is undulating with a very small ripple on the surface. The secant depth ratio is very small and the percentage loss of energy is practically zero in this case. Next is weak jump. In this type of jump, the surface rollers makes it appearance at F1 approximately equal to 1.7 and gradually increases in intensity towards the end of this range, that is F1 is equal to approximately equal to 2.5. The energy dissipation is very small in this case and it is about 5% at F1 is equal to 1.7 and it is almost 18% at F1 is equal to 2.5. Okay, this figure represents the phenomena of weak jump. Next is oscillating jump. The range of Froude number for this type of jump is 2.5 to 4.5. This category of jump is categorized by an instability of the high velocity flow in the jump, which oscillate in a random manner between the bed and the surface. Okay, these oscillations produce large surface waves that travels considerable distances downstream. The energy dissipation in this type of jump is moderate and it is about 45% at F1 is equal to 4.5. Okay, the percentage loss of energy is 45% at F1 is equal to 4.5. Next type of jump is steady jump. The range of Froude number is 4.5 to 9.0. In this range of Froude number, the jump is well established. Okay, this figure represents the steady jump. The jump is well established. The roller and jump action is fully developed to cause appreciable energy loss. The relative energy loss ranges from 45% to 70% in this case. Next is strong or choppy jump. When the Froude number of supercritical stream is greater than 9.0, then this kind of hydraulic jump takes place. In this type of jump, the water surface is very rough and choppy. The water surface downstream of the jump is also rough and wavy. The secant depth ratio is large. The secant depth ratio, that is Y2 divided by Y1, is very large in this case. And the energy dissipation is very efficient with EL upon E1 value greater than 70%. Okay. So this was all about hydraulic jump occurring in horizontal rectangular channel. In the next video, we will discuss the hydraulic jump in horizontal non-rectangular channels. Thank you.